Imagine having your own beehive, one where you can watch your bees building honeycomb, raising their young, and growing to their full potential. Now imagine having all of this in the comfort of your own home. Well, keep watching as I show you how I set up a simple observation beehive using a few low-cost supplies on this episode of Animals for the Win. I've always loved watching insects, and I had a few ant farms growing up. So one day when I was thinking about bees, I thought it would be cool to have my own hive indoors and be able to watch how they do their thing. So I got to thinking about the most economical way to do this. First, I decided to use an aquarium since I already had one. Truthfully, you could use almost any kind of container to keep your bees. Early beekeepers used clay pots to keep bees as long as 3,000 years ago, and settlers were still using clay pots to keep bees during the 1800s. Honeybees can adapt and thrive in the most unique of circumstances. Next, I turned the aquarium on its side to give my bees easy access to a clear plastic tube which serves as their connection to the outside world. Keep in mind, if you decide to use plastic tubing, most insects have a difficult time climbing up slippery plastic tubing. So for the parts where I need the bees to climb up, I used a piece of wood covered with a screen and then drilled a hole through the window pane so that they could get out. The wooden piece is shaped like a trough to make room for the bees to get through, and the screen is stapled tightly to the wood. I used a shaper table to cut a trough down a 2x4, but anyone could fasten a few pieces of wood together with nails or glue to get the same effect. I used Elmer's wood glue for any places that needed it. I have found in the past that certain adhesives like window sealant give off harmful fumes which could kill or weaken insects and their kin. That's pretty much all you need to get started. The bees will take care of the rest. I purchased a nook of bees, placed them in the aquarium with the queen, and in no time, they began to build honeycomb on the sides of the glass. Some things to keep in mind. Bees will usually go towards the light. This created a problem for my glass aquarium. I have to keep my bees covered up until I want to look inside the hive. Bees like to keep their hive warm, so insulation is helpful. Honeybees are also susceptible to problems with humidity, so ventilation is also a plus. Naturally, you will want the entire system to be carefully sealed up and secured. Having a tube pop out of place can be a nightmare and could lead to the loss of large amounts of worker bees. Finally, plan ahead. If your beehive is successful, you will have bees flying in and out of the entrance to the hive. Once they get established, your honeybees will eventually need to expand. Apiaries only sell bees once a year in the spring. You will only get one chance each year, so make it count. Order bees as early as possible, because most places that sell bees will sell out before the season even begins. Good luck, and thanks for watching Animals for the Win.